Alrighty guys, welcome back. Today we are doing one that kind of ties into one that we've done before. It's kind of around the same scheme, you know, that we've done before. This is Heart's Barracuda, and this kind of goes back with Death on Two Legs a little bit, right?
It kind of reminds me of Death on Two Legs, right?
Okay, so what's the story behind this one?
Because the story actually is that these guys, Ann and Nancy Wilson, who are the two singers and guitar players and whatnot in the band, you'll see them here in just a second, they actually wrote this as a shot at a former record label called Mushroom Records that sued them, and they're just bad blood going back and forth. And it all started with, well, I can't say it all started, but a big part of it was that they were at a concert.
Okay.
And the promoter of the concert came up to Ann Wilson and asked her how her lover was.
Okay.
And she thought that the guy was talking about her then boyfriend, who was also in the band.
Okay.
And he said, No. No, your lover, your sister. And she's going, what are you talking about? Indicating, or at least alluding to the fact that the two sisters were lesbians.
Okay.
And so, you know, all hell broke loose, basically. Okay, is what it, you know, is what it amounted to. And so Ann Wilson goes back to their hotel and writes this song.
against
the record label, right. And again, it was their former
record label. Right.
Yeah.
So there was somebody new.
Yeah. Right. So as I was reading the backstory,
it kind of reminded you of Death.
It kind of reminded me of what Freddie wrote. Freddie and Queen. You know,
it did on two legs. Yeah,
right?
yeah.
The Wilsons will say in general that, you know, the record industry is cutthroat. This stuff happens. Everybody's backbiting. Everybody's going after everybody's
throats.
Yeah. And that's what a barracuda is. I mean, they could have called it piranha.
Right.
You know, but they didn't. They call it barracuda. And it kind of, the other thing, and this is just a total off side note.
Okay.
In regard to barracuda and how dangerous they are.
Right.
I was on a fishing trip down in Florida.
Okay.
On one of those boats that takes you out to hotspot number one and
hotspot number two.
And you,
or it's like drop fishing.
Drop fishing type stuff.
Yeah, I did one of those.
Everybody's reeling up their stuff, and because they're going, got it, got the big one, they're reeling it in.
They're all barracuda.
And all of a sudden, the thing comes up, and only half the fish is there. And they found out that there was a swarm of barracuda that we were sitting on top of. And it was eating, and what we were doing, we were actually feeding them, because we were catching the fish that normally would have been swimming away from them. We were catching them.
And trapping them,
and the barracuda were eating them on the way up.
Oh my God.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
So, think about how they were, you know,
that's talking about this.
But anyway, you know, I thought it was a cool song. Always have. It's not one of their number one hits. I mean, it's not. They have other hits that are more popular than this. I don't know. I think this got to like number 11 or something like that. But anyway, I just thought it was interesting, and I saw that kind of parallel
in the connection.
and I went, you know, this is, so it didn't just happen to Queen.
Right.
It happens to probably everybody. You know, so anyway,
you good?
I'm awesome.
Alrighty, let's get started, guys.
Sounds mean.
Yeah.
It sounds angry.
I can hear it. Well, that was an ending. That was definitely an interesting ending to that.
I'm gonna tell you, just listening to that, because Anne wrote the lyrics and Nancy wrote most of the music, apparently. Okay. And you can hear, I mean, just from the music, mm-hmm. you can hear she was ticked off a little bit.
Yeah.
You can hear the anger in the music. Mm-hmm. But, you know, when you hear them live, you don't necessarily really get all the lyrics.
Right.
And, mm-hmm. you know, and it's kind of hard to understand some of the things. So I pulled the lyrics up, and just to remind myself, you know, it's funny because, you know, she talks about, you know, there was a day when we would do this stuff for free, mm-hmm. you know, trying to get yeah. up and going and all that kind yeah. of stuff. And, you know, then, you know, turns out that, you know, because there was no right, there was no wrong, we were just trying to sell a song.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? Okay. Yeah. And a name and that kind of thing.
So in the lyrics, it's kind of, it's their story along with it as well.
It seems that way. And then it gets to the point where, which the main chorus is that, you know, if the real thing don't do the trick, you better make up something quick.
Yeah.
Okay? And I think this was, I'm pretty sure that part was the lash out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, because, you know, then she's like, you're going to burn.
Right.
You know, that this is... You know, if the truth doesn't work and you have to make something up,
right?
Okay, mm-hmm. you're gonna burn. Okay, and then Barracuda. You know,
yeah.
You guys are the Barracuda. So anyway, it's pretty interesting. I thought it was pretty interesting. I always liked the song. But, yeah, you know,
I haven't really heard the song before, and. Looking at that, you know, I give them props just in itself for going out there as two women. Just going mm-hmm. out there and being in a band
okay.
of women. Because a lot of times you see men doing it. And maybe, you know...
You might have a lead singer or something who's the only female in the whole
right, band. Right.
Here they're playing and writing and doing
everything.
And doing
right, the whole thing. Right. So I give them props for that. It sucks that even with, you know... Well, I shouldn't say even with, but with, you know, everything that was going on. This was 1977,
right.
You know, and how record companies were and management deals and whatnot, that it was happening, to everybody, you know, and it wasn't just like all these high, you know, number one, number two, number three groups, whatever, that it was everybody. It was down the list, you know.
But, you know, you brought up an interesting point in mm-hmm. regard to giving them props as being female.
Right.
Because it seems females in a male-run industry.
Yeah. I guess you could say it that way.
You know, almost makes me want to give them more props.
Right.
You know, being mm-hmm. able to even break into it in the first place, mm-hmm. to get to this point. You know, and of course we have, you know, great female singers and artists and stuff like that. But it started
as a male run industry.
But you know, and the rock side of things mm-hmm. was really male run.
Yeah.
As far as I can remember. Mm-hmm. You know, there were other genres that you could break into because it was easier and then cross over.
Right, but going straight into the rock scene.
So, what it looks like they did was really, it was actually pretty remarkable. Or mm-hmm. you could have been a film star and you had a hit
right.
on a soundtrack or something,
yeah, yeah.
you know, and then all of a sudden, you're in the industry, mm-hmm. you know. But that was pretty cool. I just always liked the drive
yeah.
of the whole song.
Yeah.
You know, so anyway. But... Hey, I'm good.
You're good?
Yep.
All right, on to the announcements. Hit it, guys!
Now it's time for the announcements.
All right, first thing on the announcements today, guys, remember if you have a song that you'd like to request, or songs that you'd like to request, that link, that Google Forms link, is always down in the description below. We highly encourage you to leave your songs there, because yes, occasionally will we probably spot one of the songs you're suggesting in a comment or on social media. Yes, we probably will, but we're going to be more driven to look for them in that Google Forms link, because that's just an organized place where we can all go, for us to go and for you all to go, and it just makes it super easy for all of us, and they're all just listed down for us, you know, so it's not, you know, oh, I thought I saw this here, let me go back 3 days so then maybe I can catch it again. Or, you know, we're in a live stream and you say, well, I put in a comment a few days ago, you know, about this song, did you see it? Yeah. You know, well, that was a few days ago, we've got a lot of comments since then, and it's driving up our, you know, our comment box and whatnot. So put your song in the Google form in that entry so that it's a guarantee that we will see it, that we will see it.
And just to go just one step further with that, not to...
No, go ahead.
You know, elongate anything.
Go ahead.
But remember, you're putting your songs in, what your song requests in with, you know, with everybody else.
Right.
Right. Mm-hmm. So, you know, if we've got a list of 60 songs and we're only doing five songs
a week
or
six songs a week. Right.
Like, okay. It may be a while. So, but don't think that we don't have it. It's
right.
Kind of like, you know, it's kind of like when we used to call the local radio station, mm-hmm. and for their request hour, and, you know, they get 50 things, and what do they play with all their ads? Maybe 8 songs.
Right.
You can't, you know, so, yeah, we do have your stuff. Mm-hmm. It's organized, and, you know, it's getting in the playlist.
Right.
So, is what it amounts to.
Right.
So, just... to keep kind of keep that in mind.
Yeah,
that's all. Okay, go ahead. All
right, on to the next one. Make sure to check out Coffee First Scheme later up in the corner. We've got some amazing vlogs, challenges, whatnot coming out over there. Mm-hmm. So make sure you go over there, subscribe over there, make sure you watch those, and give Courtney and me the support that, you know, that we've been getting here, you know, on this channel. But make sure you can go over and give us support, you know, over there as well. I know she would really, really, really appreciate that. Don't forget that the Teespring link is also down in the description below, where you can get your hoodies, t-shirts, long sleeve t-shirts, tank tops now that it's getting warmer outside, mugs, phone cases, and all that great stuff. That link is down in the description below, as well as the Patreon link that's also down in the description below. Patreon is the membership that you can get to the channel, and you can get a whole bunch of perks just for signing up, such as... description mentions and shoutouts, which you automatically get even for putting in, you know, on a lower tier or the lowest tier, you automatically get description mentions and shoutouts. You can get discount codes for the Teespring shop. You can get behind the scenes looks. And most importantly, you get exclusive videos only onto Patreon that will not come out onto YouTube. So make sure if you'd like to get any of that cool stuff, you can become a Patreon member down below. Mm-hmm. I do get to thank the following patrons who have pledged to make this video possible and for being awesome, sticking with us through this whole uncharted territory that nobody even imagined 2020 we'd be going through. That'd be Teresa Anderson, Hot Space, and Petro, Karen Barone, Sandy Thomas, Courtney Truax, Cindy Rice, and Dawn Kula. Thank you so much for your constant love and support, guys. We highly appreciate it, and we hope you stick with us through the duration of all this madness.
Absolutely.
So, thank you so much for that. And last but not least, remember, guys, that at 1,000, we do have that goal, that at 1,000, we will open up the P.O. box. If you would like to send us any fan mail, whether that be letters, drawings, peanut butter, chocolate fudge, snickerdoodles, any other junk food for him, you know, you can do that. We got to get to 1,000 first. We are 90 away at the point of this recording that we're filming this. We are 90 away. So if you
That's
would like
cool.
to help us get to the 1,000 and you are new, we highly encourage you to subscribe. We mentioned Patreon earlier, you know, and if that's not your thing, but you still want to stay connected, subscribing is the easiest way to do that. So that button is down below,
yep.
And if you aren't subscribed, it'll be red and it'll say subscribe. And it's super easy. It just takes 2 clicks, one for that subscribe button and one for the post notification bell that will come up afterwards, so you get notified whenever we go live, have a premiere, a video goes out, or anything else, you know, you will be connected, you will be involved. So if that works for you, click that subscribe button down below.
Absolutely.
Anyway, anything else I'm missing today?
No. You're good.
All right. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to smack that like button, subscribe if you're new, and we'll see you on the next one. Peace out, guys.